Hi everyone, we're here at Black Hat 2017. We're on the second floor. There's like a whole other, anyway, it's hard to, never mind. So we're here with Jim Rivas, CEO of Cloud Security Alliance. Jim, welcome.
Well, thanks very much. And this is actually the nonprofit ghetto of Black Hat. So welcome here. Hold on your wallet, but it's a great part of Black Hat.
I was almost mugged walking in. I had to run. It was frightening. So you are a nonprofit organization. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what the Cloud Security Alliance is and what it does?
Yeah, absolutely. We're a global not-for-profit research organization, and we're building the best practices on how you secure cloud computing, a lot of the other issues that are coming up, IoT. We're starting to get into things like blockchain, artificial intelligence, all these tools and technologies we're going to need. And then we do a lot of research, education, best practices, a certification of those things. So we're an organization that's a very large ecosystem. All the cloud providers of note, banks, they all help participate so we can create this. And we kind of herd the cats
to
get the research out.
So when I hear best practice, I believe a lot of people kind of misconstrue that as, well, this is what you should do, and you don't have to think beyond what the best practice is. Educate people and say, well, yeah, the best practice is a good starting point, it's a guideline, but how do you recommend people use these best practice guides?
Yeah. That's a very good point, and we sometimes call them awesome best practices, but the reality is that a lot of this is also explaining issues that we don't totally have resolved, and a lot of the communications is, this is a shared responsibility, this is a journey, it's not a destination, you have to understand your risks, you can't just throw your problems across the wall to a cloud provider or one of the security vendors, you got to take this holistic approach, but you also have to be realistic and say, hey, if I am doing some low-risk things in cloud, maybe I don't need to provide give the provider like a 300-question checklist, which we do have. We make those things.
Yeah.
But when you're doing more serious things, then you need to think accordingly. But we're encouraging people to really understand you have to be a lot more agile. Gone are the days when you could do a six-month risk assessment before onboarding a new application.
I totally agree. And even when you just say cloud, you know, there's software as a service, there's platform as a service, there's now containers and microservices. So when you say cloud, it's all encompassing of those technologies, and do you have best practices that you're working on for all those?
Yeah, we really excited yesterday we released, it was a long time coming after 6 years, an update to our guidance, our overall guidance, and we've added a section on containers, on how you do software-defined networking to create like micro-segmentation inside of these. How do you employ CASB's cloud access security brokers, because a lot of that is not completely baked yet, and even like container technology
hasn't even gone in the oven yet.
I think in a while here, containers are going to be very secure, but right now there aren't very good standards. So we came out with, we think, some of the first guidance.
There are no standards. Well, there are. Everyone has their own standard.
There's the bad things are only one standard or a million standards, and we're probably more on the million side right now.
But thanks to organizations like yourselves helping kind of herd all the cats with the standards and best practices, I'm hopeful that we'll have some guidance for customers that are looking to implement cloud and whatever the next iteration are that might include containers or microservices or whatever that is.
Yeah, we're starting to get some sanity there. We just recently, a survey said that 2/3 of U.S. Cloud tenants are aligning to our best practices, but it is something that we're going to have to be able to change those things. Someone's trying to sneak
I'm
trying to keep track of our employees. I think we've lost about two of them at Black Hat so far. So after this, I'm going down to the craps table or some rehab or maybe the pokey, and we'll go find them. But we have to be agile here. We can't just have the very sort of brittle architectures. Everything software defined. Think virtually in terms of your security controls and collaborate. One big message that we've kind of come out of this Black Hat and others is we can't operate like sort of independent private fire departments anymore and let the building across burn down. We've got to share incidents, indicators of compromise, and these best practices a lot more rapidly, because the bad guys are doing it now better than ever.
So now organizations that want to learn more about the best practices and standards and guidelines for cloud, Where do they go? They just go to the website and they download it for free? Do they have to register? Is there a fee? Like, how does it work?
Yeah. We are a great nonprofit, terrible business model. So all the research is free. Go to cloudsecurityalliance.org/research and you can download our new guidance. You can download our control frameworks, all these sorts of things. Everything you want to be able to look at this from a high level governance down to very detailed technical prescriptive types of controls you should be employing.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Jim.
Thanks, Paul.